Yo, what's going on YouTube? This is Sack Juggalo and I'm back with another one. We're coming with an artist called 360. This is a track called Tiny Angel. And I don't know if this is part of it, but six. I don't know if there's like a ill mind thing going on here, but this is six. Looks like it's going to be pretty deep. It says the following video contains subject matter that might be distressing to some viewers. So everybody strap in and be ready for a real one. This song comes as a request from Lachlan Noel. Appreciate you, Lachlan. You're riding shotgun with me on this one, and welcome back to the channel, man. You've been a great supporter. I also want to thank all the new subscribers out there who subbed and gotten us over the 250 mark. We're halfway to our first goal, where we're going to be giving away a gift card at 500 subscribers. And then we're going to be giving another gift card away at 1,000 subscribers. All you'll need to do is subscribe to the channel and drop a comment. You'll be entered in for the contest. So make sure if you want to be in that contest, you just do those two simple things. Hit the sub, hit the comments, and you're in. If you happen to like this video, please hit the like button. Get those likes up there. And let's get into this video. I'm expecting a pretty intense journey here.
So this story is about a really close friend of mine. I love you, brother.
Okay, so this is a story of his friends that he's going to tell. Okay.
Mates talk shit about their wives, but I love mine. Yeah, we fight sometimes, but ain't that just life? She's been pregnant now for some time. It took us years and enough tries. I thought it wouldn't happen from my young life. From the drunk times of when I tried drugs twice, I thought downstairs had gone and messed it up right. The doctor told me that I need to stop stressing. The only thing that's working against us is just time. That was true. 2 months by, my wife called me up while I was working at the pub, right? She told me I was gonna be a daddy. We both broke down. She said there's something that I'd done right. I called my mother, told her I was gonna be a father. Mum cried, so did I. I was tongue-tied.
So I don't know how many of you are out there parents, but I'm a parent. And you pretty much have that epiphany of when you're told that you're going to have a child, that, you know, that's what matters now. That's my focus. That's, I need to do everything in life for, you know, my child now. Yeah, so when you get that call, man, just, you kind of think of everything that you could do, you know, for that child. And even though you're thinking of everything that you could do for the child, you still can't think of everything. So there's always going to be more that you could do for it, because you don't know, you know, as a new parent, even what comes along with being a parent. You know, my daughter now is 19, almost 20 years old. So she's alive. She's in the workforce. I love you, baby girl, if you're watching this. But yeah, man, it was a blessing to have a child, you know, and to have someone that's part you out there in the world doing things, you know, and it really is miraculous, man. I like this so far. I don't know if it's going to take a weird, dark turn, but in the beginning it said it's going to be distressing, so I can only imagine there's something pretty epic about to happen.
In this feeling, but I love life. I've never had a purpose, and this had just become mine. To create this little person, it's fun size, a little bit of her and a little bit of me. But I pray he gets his mum's eyes. I say he, cause I've always wanted a son, right? The ultrasound said it's a boy. My little ray of sunshine, it dawned on me. I can't wait to see my son rise. You know what they say about time though? It does fly. Fast forward 9 months and suddenly it's crunch time. It's been a few days of going through contractions. Gotta stop watch time and every moment that it happens. We reach 5 minutes, so it's hospital time. I call ahead to see the doctors arrive. My wife's laughing how I properly drive, like the cops are behind. But there was barely any traffic, so we got there in time. I'm a little scared, but she ain't got a worry in sight. She's a warrior, exactly what you want in a wife. It's been several days of epic pain. Every day she wakes up, finally she's coming to that second stage of labor. I sit next to her, squeeze on her hand, put a sponge up on her head and say, breathe if you can. I love you so much, baby, you're so strong. I could never do this, but you so easily can.
Man, I cannot tell you how accurate he is telling this story. It really is almost too freaking real, man. I mean, he's really going in on every aspect of it. This is crazy, man. This is good. This is really good. Shout out to you, 360. This is really, really well put together, man.
She said the pain is insane, like her abdomen's ruptured. Like someone's got a knife and they stab in her stomach. She's like, we have to do something. The nurse said it's natural, relax. It's just a sign that it's actually coming. She's like, no, it's too much. It's too hard to get out. I'm saying any words I think will help her calming her down. Doctor's like, you're nearly through the worst part of it now. Take a look and see my little king is starting to crown. They all telling her to push. And she's screaming, she's saying that it hurts. I tell her to keep breathing. It's like push is the only word that they've said now. Then I'm shocked by the massive scream she lets out. The doctor's like, yes, now the head's out. And then I watch as he quickly pulling the rest out. It's so amazing to see my son in the flesh. I can't help but notice he hasn't taken a breath now. They put a little plastic thing in his mouth while the doctor's two fingers are slightly pumping his chest down. I start panicking. Something's gone wrong, they push me to the side. I can barely see what's going on. He's not breathing, they need to resuscitate him. He's suffocating, I see that it's something major. I feel so helpless, I wish I could come and save him. I pray that my son will make it, it's taken him fucking ages. Everyone's in shock, I'm just listening in, holding my breath, wishing I could give it to him. Fuck, at 20 minutes, now they're stopping.
That was one of the realest bars I think I've ever heard in my life, dude. He's just wishing that he could put his breath inside his child. This is not easy to watch, man. This is some real shit. Wow.
Fucking ages, everyone's in shock. I'm just listening in, holding my breath, wishing I could give it to him. Fuck, at 20 minutes, now they're stopping. They turn around, they say we've lost him. I'm in shock, I can't talk. I'm staring at the ground. I can't walk.
Again, man. That's a pain that I hope no one ever has to feel. I don't even know how to speak on it because I've never experienced something that dramatic. You know, I've had family members die in my life, but your own kid right out of the womb? That would be a tough one to get over, man. That would be tough to get over.
Shot, I can't talk. I'm staring at the ground. I can't walk. They hand him to us. Can't believe the size of him. The most beautiful thing I've ever seen, but there's no life in him. My wife's crying. Like, why aren't they reviving him? I said they tried for 20 minutes. She's like, try again. Now I'm feeling like I'm stuck in hell. This is the worst pain I've fucking felt. I've been 10 years clean, but now I'm drunk and on the drugs as well. I'm doing anything to numb myself, but nothing helps. I believed in God, for that I feel dumb as hell. Can someone please tell God to go and fuck himself? I'm sorry, oh, it's hard to be faithful. It's painful. Heaven must be running out of angels. He died from asphyxiation, no air in his lungs. A parent should never have to bury their son, especially one that's so precious it has barely begun. That's one thing in life that should never be done. I prayed for his son, and they blessed me with one. My biggest gift, now his presence is up. And I'm crying at the thought he won't ever feel a hug or the tenderness of love that he'd be getting from his mum, sent him from above. But why take him? It's like I'm being punished for the negative I've done, and it's killing me. The Christmas time is barely in a month, so I'm doing what I have to do to spend it with my son.
Where did you go? Are you alone? How did you get there?
Wow. 360 Tiny Angel. I'll have the link in the description down below, so you guys go check out his music, man, because I know I want to check out more. The dude's a masterful storyteller. The subject matter, yeah, it was deep. You know, it was hard to listen to. To think that there's parents out there that, well, I mean, we all know that there's parents out there that lose their kids, you know, at birth, and sometimes it's the mother that loses her life. But I tell you what, it never gets any easier hearing about it. That's for damn sure, because, you know, there, people like myself, we were fortunate enough to have a child, and she grew up to be healthy and smart, and she's in the workforce, and she's moved out of the house, and, you know, she's making her own life now, and one day she'll have a child, and she'll be able to hopefully experience that same, you know, joy of motherhood and being a parent. Man, I honestly could not imagine the pain that this parent went through, having to deal with this, and then getting back into the drugs and alcohol after he's been clean for 10 years. And, you know, that it will. I mean, I can honestly tell you that something like that would probably put you back, you know, 20 years in your life, just to put you back and you're trying to find a way out. That was a difficult song. Yo, Lackland, man, I appreciate you, dude. That was a great request and an amazing song. A new artist that I definitely have to subscribe to. Give a like up on that video, because that was real, man. You can't get any more real than that. I mean, this is what we're talking about. This is hip-hop, man. Hip-hop is about life and substance. And if you ain't got that, man, you ain't got shit. So I hope you guys like this reaction. I hope you love the video. If you do, go show the boy some love, man. He's really got it going on. In fact, how old is this song? Let's see. Okay, it just came out last year, so it's a little less than a year old. This was amazing, man. You definitely go show dude some love, man. I can't wait to see what else he's got out there, because definitely interested in hearing another piece. If you guys are interested in the gift card giveaway, just go ahead and hit that subscribe button and leave a comment. That'll enter you in the contest. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace. We'll be right back.